The turbo oil feed and return lines are a common leak area on the Mini Cooper S R56. Last September, I did a major overhaul to put an end to all oil leaks with new gaskets for the oil filter housing and new lines from Mamba. This kit was affordable and built with quality materials, but then here I am few months later with a massive oil leak in the same area. Let me show you what was the issue and how to avoid it. First, let me go back to when I started the kit. Although it is not necessary to put the front end in service mode, trust me, it will save you blood, tears, and some skin too. Check this Pelican Parts article. It's not that hard and it will take you between 30 minutes to 1 hour. The first potential issue to mention is the Mamba kit Banjo bolts that have very small opening compared to the stock ones. This can cause oil starvation. I reused the old Banjo bolts with the crash washers that came with the new kit. Investigating the oil leak comeback. Don't call it a comeback. I've been here for days. It was coming from the oil return line gasket or O-ring. I am not the only one that had this issue.
So number one, this here is a rubber O-ring. So this is the one that came on the Mamba kit. So the issue that I'm having is that because this is now like rock hard, it's not exactly sealing as it should.
For me, the gasket and O-ring became this hard and brittle in less than a year. Here is a stock oil return line O-ring that I took off last year for reference. It is still in better shape than the new one from Mamba. I bought this O-ring kit on Amazon. It is rated for 120 degrees Celsius, which is the recommended temp rating for this O-ring in particular. In Mamba's defense, I talked to this guy from BTR channel. He said that he runs the Mamba kit on the minis he worked on and he never had this issue. I contacted Mamba to ask for explanations. They didn't respond yet. I will post updates if any.